Greetings. Let us learn about the role of epinephrine injection. Epinephrine is available either in a vial or in a prefilled syringe. So it's important for us to learn about the dose of epinephrine that is used either to control bleeding or to prevent bleeding. And the epinephrine that is in the vial is about 1 in 1,000 dilution, that is typically 1 mg/mL. When you want to use epinephrine for hemostasis, then we use 1 in 10,000 dilution, that is 0.1 mg/mL. On the other hand, if you want to use epinephrine to prevent bleeding during polyp resection, either endoscopic mucosal resection, i.e. EMR, or endoscopic submucosal dissection, i.e. ESD, then we use a little more diluted epinephrine at 1 in 100,000 dilution, that is 0.01 mg/mL. For hemostasis, 1 in 10,000. For EMR, 1 in 100,000. So let us learn about epinephrine injection for peptic ulcer bleeding control. So you want to use 1 in 10,000 dilution. For EMR, especially large EMR, you need to take a 100cc saline bag and add epinephrine and create a dilution of 1 in 100,000. Some endoscopists even go further and create a dilution of 1 in 200,000. So we have the solution ready. And you have to pick an injection catheter. There are two types of injection catheters that are available in the market. One with a metal outer sheath, like a metal catheter. And this has advantages when you have to go through a tortuous portion of the colon and then want to get your needle out. This catheter works very well and the needle will come out. Either with a tortuous colon or trying to do an injection of a sphincterotomy bleed in a patient undergoing ERCP or trying to reach the fundus of the stomach in a retroflex position. Otherwise, the regular plastic catheter, injection catheter, works for most of the other situations. It's important to get into the habit of priming the injection catheter every time to get rid of the bubbles. It's very important not to have bubbles and prime the catheter. So let us look at the various indications where epinephrine has been shown to be useful. First, peptic ulcer bleeding. When it comes to peptic ulcer bleeding, you take a 1 in 10,000 dilution and you go to the site and inject epinephrine in and around the vessel. And you can inject 5 to 10 ml, which will control the bleeding. But the Oriental group have shown that you could also inject between 13 to 20 ml, which has been shown to be a lot more effective in control of the bleeding and preventing re-bleeding. So this is, and as we know, epinephrine causes vasospasm and stops the bleeding. It's important whenever you treat peptic ulcer bleeding and you use epinephrine, because the effect is temporary, you should follow up with additional means of controlling bleed. either with the use of a heater probe to cauterize the vessel, or you could use a gold probe or a bipolar probe to cauterize the vessel. So for peptic ulcer bleeding, epinephrine injection, small amount or large amount, and the additional use of cautery, important. When you see a large pedunculated polyp, which has lots of feeding vessels, they are at high risk for bleeding, and you could cut down that immediate bleeding by epinephrine injection, either into the stalk or stalk as well as the head of the polyp, and it causes vasospasm, it decreases the size of the polyp if you give enough time. Enough time, I mean, if you see a polyp in the sigmoid colon, it is large pedunculated polyp, almost obliterating the lumen, and in that case, you inject the head of the polyp, the stalk of the polyp with epinephrine, maybe 2 to 3 ml at each site, and then you let that epi act, and you let the epi act by going up all the way to the cecum, and then coming back. During that time, the epinephrine will act and reduce the size of the polyp. This is known as epinephrine volume reduction, and that allows us to safely cut the polyp. Sometimes the patients can come back with post-polypectomy bleeding, and if that happens again, epinephrine can be used either alone or with an additional technique. Again, it requires injection of epinephrine to control the bleeding. Another cause of bleeding that epinephrine may be useful is in the case of diverticular bleeding. And in case of diverticular bleeding, the bleed can come from the dome of the diverticulum or the neck or mouth of the diverticulum, close to the opening. And when you have a patient with diverticular bleeding, one of the important concepts to keep in mind is not a bad idea, once you identify a particular diverticulum is bleeding, before you inject, you may want to put a tattoo so that you can identify the site. And the reason I say this is, if there were to be a contraction wave, and the scope slips out, and you can't find that diverticulum that bled, it is going to be a mess. By getting into the habit of putting a tattoo, and you will know where that diverticulum is, where the source of bleeding is. And there are several different options for controlling diverticular bleeding. Again, epinephrine injection can be used to cause vasospasm and arrest of the bleed. It's always important to keep in mind, whenever we use epinephrine, if technically feasible, to add another measure, one should follow up with that. In these cases, one could either use a clip or a cautery, depending upon the bleeding site. If it is in the dome, better to clip. If it is at the neck, you could either cauterize or clip. Another source of bleeding is cecal angioectasias or ascending colon angioectasias. Most of us try to cauterize these vessels straight, but it has been reported that cecal cauterization can precipitate delayed post-polypectomy syndrome and even delayed perforation. And I personally feel that it is safer to inject epinephrine, and what happens is you will find the source vessel that is supplying this angioectasias by injecting epinephrine, because most of the capillaries will pale out except the feeding vessel, and that feeding vessel could be targeted focally with either APC or cautery. And then I try to put clips, although there is no data, I try to put clips to reinforce the wall and prevent any delayed perforation. In addition, the clip would also have an additional benefit of creating hemostasis. In terms of the complications of epinephrine, those are mostly on the heart and blood vessels. On the heart, one should think about irregular heart or arrhythmias and elevation of blood pressure or hypertension. And if there is too much of epinephrine injection in an older patient with a severe atherosclerotic vascular disease, it can precipitate ischemia of the bowel. So something to keep in mind. We've learned a lot about epinephrine injection. We've learned about the dilution that could be used, 1 in 10,000 for ulcer bleeding or active bleeding, and 1 in 100,000 or 200,000 for prevention of bleeding. And whenever we treat an active bleed, it's important to use additional measures like hemostasis or mechanical hemostasis or thermal hemostasis in the setting of peptic ulcer bleeding to reduce recurrent bleeding. I hope this is useful. Thank you.